Hello everyone, we will start with quantitative aptitude. What is quantitative and what is aptitude? Students, please answer what is quantitative and what is aptitude.
Don't know, madam.
Don't know. So today we will start with numbers. What is number? In Hindu Arabic system, we use 10 symbols 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0 to 9. These called as digits to represent any number. When we combine these digits, it form a group. It denoting a number is called as numeral. Okay, so in table here you can see the unit digit, that is degree will be 0. 10 raised to 0 will be the unit digit. When we give the degree as 1, then it in the form of 10. When 10 raised to 2, that is 100. Okay, in the 100, 100, it will be 100. Hundreds number, then in 100, then it in the form of 1000. Then 10 raised to 4 will be the 10,000. 10 raised to 5 will be the lakh. And in 10 raised to 6 will be the 10 lakhs. In crores, there will be the 7 zeros. In 10 crores, there will be the 80. Okay, we represent a number, say 6, 8, 9, 7, 4, 5, 1, 3, 2. So place, what is place value? Place value or local value of a digit in numeral. Okay, we will see the first example. Place value of 2 is 2 into 1 equals to 2. Place value of 3 is here given in example. Yeah, you can see the 6, 8, 9, 7, 4, 5, 1, 3, 2. The place value of the 2, last digit. Okay. 6 in the number 6, 8, 9, 7, 4, 5, 1, 3, 2. Okay. The place value for place value of 2 will be 2. Then place value of 3 will be 30. Place value of 1 is 100. Place value of 5 will be 5000. For place value of 4 will be 40,000. Okay. Then place value for 7 will be 7. And how many zeros? 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. It will be the 7 lakh. Place value for 7 will be 7 lakh. For 9, it will be 90 lakhs. For 8, it will be 8 crores. And for 6, it will be 60 crores. Okay. Then, place value, you have seen. Now we will see the face value. The face value of a digit in numeral is the value of the digit itself at whatever place it may be. In the above numeral, the face value of 2 will be the 2. The face value of 3 is 3. The number is the face value itself. Okay, the face value of a digit in numeral is the value of the digit itself. So, tell me the given number, that is 6, 8, 9, 7, 4, 5, 1, 3, 2. The face value of 2 will be 2. The face value of 3 will be 3. The face value of 1 will be 3. Same value itself, okay? Same digit itself is the face value of the given number. So, tell me the face value of 6, 8, 9, 7, 4, 5, 1, 3, 2. The face value of 8 will be, students answer me. Have you understood
what English is plus 7?
Dipti, Abhishek, Praveen.
Face value vicharayka?
Yes, face value.
Face value of 8.
Face value of 8 will be 8. Okay? Face value for 6.
So this will be the face value of the digit in general and the value of the digit itself. Next we will see the types of numbers. Natural numbers, when we counting numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to infinity are called as natural numbers. What is whole numbers? All counting numbers together with zero form the set of whole numbers. Without zero, it will be the natural numbers, and with zero, it will be the whole numbers. When we include the zero, then it will form as whole numbers. Zero is the only whole number which is not a natural number. Every natural number is a whole number. What is integers? All natural numbers, including zero and negatives of counting numbers, that is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, all positive numbers, negative numbers and zero together form the set of integers. Positive integers 1, 2, 3, 4, all the positive set of all positive integers, then negative integers with minus sign are included in the integers. Non-positive and non-negative integer, that is zero, is neither positive nor negative. So 0, 1, 2, 3 represents the set of non-negative integers. Why? 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 will represent the set of non-positive integers. It will be the negative integers. Okay. So, next we will see even numbers and odd numbers. Tell me what is even numbers and odd numbers. Am I audible? Please unmute yourself and answer what is even number, what is odd number.
Even number which are divisible by 2 and odd number which are not divisible by 2.
Yes, right. Even numbers, a number divisible by 2 is called as even numbers, 2, 4, 6. When we divide the given number, it is divisible by 2. That is called as even numbers. And odd numbers, a number which is not divisible by 2 is called as an odd number. Like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. 11. Okay, these all are odd numbers. Then prime numbers, a number greater than 1. Okay, a number which are greater than 1 is called a prime number. If it has exactly two factors, namely 1 and the number itself. Prime numbers up to 100 when it is divisible by 2. Okay, greater than 1, 2 is prime number. And if it has exactly two factors, namely 1 and the number itself, factors only divisible by that number, then it is prime numbers. 2 having the factor 1 and 2 number itself. When 3 is divisible by only 1 and 3, 5 it is divisible by 1 and 5 only, 7 it is divisible by 1 and 7 up to 100. These are the numbers, prime numbers up to 100, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29. You can see on the screen, these are divisible by itself and 1. Okay, for that prime numbers. Prime numbers greater than 100, let P be the given number greater than 100. To find out whether it is prime or not, we use the following method. Okay, how to find out the prime number? To find a whole number nearly greater than the square root of P, let K greater than square root of P. Test whether P is divisible by any prime number less than K. Okay, if yes, then P is not prime, otherwise P is prime. If it is divisible by any number, then it is not a prime number, otherwise it will be the prime number. Example, here we will see the example. First, we have to find whether 191 is a prime number or not. Okay, now 40 is greater than square root of 191. Prime numbers less than 14 are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. If 191 is divisible by 2, 3, 5, 7, 11 or 13, then it is not a prime number. 191 is not divisible by any of them. So 191 is a prime number. Okay. It means when we have to find the prime number, we have to check whether it is divisible by 1 and number itself. It should not be divisible by any other number. Then it is said to be the given number will be the prime number. Okay. Next, we will see what is composite numbers. Numbers greater than 1 which are not prime. Numbers greater than 1 which are not prime are known as composite numbers. Okay, we will see the numbers other than prime numbers are called as composite numbers. Here we can see, here you will see the prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7. So in between 2 to 7, the numbers will be 4, 6. Okay, these are the composite numbers. No, one is neither prime nor composite number. Okay, please remember this. One is neither prime nor composite number. Two is the only even number which is prime number. Okay, see, remember this. Two is the only even number which is prime. There are 25 prime numbers between 1 and 100. How many numbers between 1 and 100? There are 25 prime numbers. You will get the MCQ regarding this or filling the blanks, that is 25 prime numbers between 1 to 100. Again, 2 is the only even number which is prime, and 1 is neither prime nor composite number. So we will see the next, what is co-prime numbers. Two numbers A and B are said to be co-primes if their HCF is 1. We will see the what is how to calculate HCF, LCM in next chapter. Okay. So if two numbers A and B are said to be co-primes if their HCF is 1. Example 2, 3 is 1, co-primes, 4, 5 is co-primes, 7, 9 is co-primes, 8, 11 are co-prime numbers. Test of divisibility. Divisibility by 2. A number is divisible by 2 if its unit digit is any of 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Suppose a number is given like 84932. When the unit digit means last digit of the number is divisible by 2 or the unit digit is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, then the number is divisible by 2. Okay. 5, 6, 5, 9, 3, 5. unit digit is 5. Unit digit is not 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So this number is not divisible by 2. Next we will see divisibility by 3. When a number is divisible by 3, if the sum of its digit is divisible by? Its digit. Okay, we have to add or have to calculate the sum of the all the digits of the given number. When the digits of the sum of the given number is divisible by 3, then the given number will be divisible by 3 itself. Okay, so example is given as 592482 is divisible by 3. Since sum of its digit, we have to add the all numbers like 5 plus 9 plus 2, 4 plus 8 plus 2. When its sum, we will get as 30. 30 is divisible by 3. So the whole number will be divisible by 3. Now, divisibility by 4. A number is divisible by 4 if the number formed by the last two digits is divisible by 4. Okay. What we have to do is formed by the last two digits. We have to divide the last two digits by 4. Suppose example is given as 892648. In this number, the last two digits of the number is 48. Okay. So, we have to divide this 48 by 4. What will we get? 4 ones are 4 and 4 twos are 8. So, it is divisible by 4, right? So, the whole number will be divisible by 4. Now, 8 and 2. Okay, in next example is 749282. This number we have to divide the last two digits, that is 82, by 4. When we divide the 8, it will get 4 twos are 8 and 4 2. How we will divide the 4 2 divided by 4? So it is not divisible by 4 since the number formed by the last two digits is 82, which is not divisible by 4. Next, divisibility by 5. A number is divisible by 5 if its unit digit is either 0 or 5. Thus, 2820 and 50345 are divisible by 5, while 30934409 46 are not, because when the unit digit of given number is either 0 or 5, then it will be divisible by 5. Next is divisibility by 6. A number is divisible by 6 if it is divisible by both 2 and 3. That is, 2 into 3 will be 6. We have to check the divisibility by 2. That is, unit digit we have to check, and for divisibility by 3, we have to check the sum of the digits for which have to be divisible by 3. Okay. So how will we calculate the given number 35256? Please answer whether it is divisible by 2 and 3. If it is divisible by 2 and 3, then it is divisible by 6 or 6 also. Okay. Have you
answered? Ma'am, but sorry for disturbing, ma'am.
Yes.
But what, when we are now you have said that it is 2 and 3, या दोघांनी जर divisible होत असेल तरच मग 6 ने divisible होणार ते, बरोबर ma'am?
हो.
मग 3 साठी मग आपल्याला ते पूर्ण सम हे करून चेक करायला लागेल ना, त्यासाठी आधी ऍड करून.
हा, पहिले आपल्याला 2 ने डिव्हिजिबल बघायचं असेल तर आपण काय करणार, युनिट डिजिट चेक करणार, बरोबर?
हो.
it should be divisible by 2, right? Manje 6 is divisible by 2, right? Last digit is 6 and it is divisible by 2, okay?
Yes.
Then we also have to check with 3, whether it is divisible by 3 or not. So we will add these numbers, okay? So we have added the number 3, 5, 2, 5, 6, okay? We get the 21, which is divisible by 3, right?
Yes.
Yes, thus 3, 5, 2, 5, 6 is divisible by 2 as well as 3. Hence,
3
is divisible by 6.
6.
Yes, we have to check whether it is divisible by 2 as well as 3.
Whether if it's not divisible by 3, then what we will do over there?
No, no. Then it is not divisible by 6 also.
Okay, then it will not divisible by 6 also.
Yes, yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, now we will proceed. We will check with divisibility by 8. Okay. If number is if the number formed by the last 3 digits of the given number is divisible by 8. For a divisibility by 4, we have seen what we have seen. If the number formed by the last 2 digits, then it is divisible by 4. And for 8, divisibility by 8, we have to check the last 3 digits of the given number, then it will be divisible by 8. Okay, we have to check last 3 digits for divisibility by 8. Okay, if the last 3 digits will be divisible by 8, then the rule follow. Okay. For divisibility by 9, if the number is divisible by 9, we have to check the sum of the digits is divisible by 9. Okay. We also we have seen the this rule for 3 also. Okay. Since the sum of the digits, which is 18, which is divisible by 9. And for the if the sum of the digits which is divisible by 3, then it is divisible by 3. And if the sum of the digits is divisible by 9, then this rule follows for divisibility by 9. Next, we will see the divisibility rule for by 10. A number is divisible by 10 if it ends with 0 only. Okay. For 5, divisibility by 5, we have to check whether the last digit is 0 or 5. Okay. And in divisibility by 10, we have to check whether the number last digit is 0. Okay. If it ends with 0, then it follows the rule that is divisibility by 10. Okay. In like example, 96410, if it ends with 0, then this number, any number, if it ends, last digit is divisible, ends with 0, then it is divisible by 10. Okay. Now we will see the divisibility by 11. If a number is divisible by 11, the difference of the sum of its digits at odd places. This rule is very important. Please follow this. Like if the difference of the sum of its digits at odd places and the sum of its digits at even places is either 0 or a number divisible by 11. Okay, please understand this. If the example is 4832718, this is the number, we have to check whether it is divisible by 11. Okay, so we will check. What is we have to do is sum of digits at odd places. Okay, odd places we have to follow from odd places. We will start with 4, 3. Okay, first number is 4, then 3, then 7, and last one is 8. Okay, one place. At second place is 8, then third place will be odd place, that is 3, then at second will be the even place, 7th will be the odd place, For 1, it is even place, and for 8, it will be the odd place. Okay, please understand this. Okay, sum of the digits at new odd places is 8, 7, 3, 4, and minus 1, 2, 8. Okay, it will be 10, 11, and this will be the we get as 11, which is divisible by 11. Balaika?
Ma'am, can you please repeat it again?
Balaika, Abhishek?
थोड कन्फ्यूज आहे मॅम, ते जसं तुम्ही मला सांगितलं की 4 3
काय करा बघा, ऑड प्लेसेस कुठून स्टार्ट होतो तुम्ही काउंट करा, 1 पासून, 1 प्लेस, सेकंड प्लेस, थर्ड प्लेस. ओके, वी हॅव टू स्टार्ट विथ लेफ्ट हँड साइड. 4 विल बी कोणती प्लेस येणार, ऑड, फर्स्ट प्लेस, बरोबर. त्याच्यानंतर 8 ची प्लेस येणार इवन प्लेस, मग 3 ची प्लेस येणार ऑड प्लेस. सो वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट सम ऑफ डिजिट्स ऍट ऑड प्लेसेस मायनस सम ऑफ डिजिट्स ऍट इवन प्लेसेस. सो इट विल बी 22 मायनस 11, वी गेट ऍज 11, विच इज डिविजिबल बाय 11. प्लीज ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड. प्लीज इफ यू नॉट अंडरस्टँडिंग, यू हॅव टू टेक पेन अँड पेपर, यू हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट दिस. ओके, we will see the next divisibility by 12. Divisibility by 12. So a number is divisible by 12 if it is divisible by both 4 and 3. Consider the number 34632. The number formed by last two digits is 32, which is divisible by 4. So, divisibility, how to check the divisible by 12? If it is divisible by both numbers, that is 4 and 3. How to check the divisible by 4? We have to check the last two digits, that is 32. If the last two digits is divisible by 4, then it is divisible by 12. And if the sum of the digits of the number, given number, is divisible by 3, then it is divisible by 3. Okay, we have to check whether it is divisible by both 4 and 3. Then it is, the given number is divisible by 12. Okay, now we will see it, whether the number is divisible by 14. If the number is divisible by 2 as well as 7, that the given number is divisible by 40. We have to check the number is divisible by 2 as well as 7. Okay, 7 2s are, it will be get as 40. If the number is given divisible by 2 as well as 7, then it will divisible by 14. Divisibility by 15. Hello students, we will end this meeting here. We will continue in next lecture. Okay. Please practice at home what we have seen yet. Okay.
Can you just share this PDF on the group?
Yes, yes, I will share it on WhatsApp. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks.